Welcome back to Kids Fun Science. My name's Ken, and today's experiment is the homemade pH indicator red cabbage juice experiment. As always, adult supervision is required. What you need for this experiment is cups, cabbage, sugar, baking soda, water, bleach, Sprite, sanitizer, vinegar, knife, and a blender, and an adult. To start off the experiment, we're going to cut it in half and use half of a red cabbage. Once we cut it in half, we're going to cut that red cabbage into strips. The red cabbage contains a natural pH indicator that changes colors according to the acidity of the solution. This is very easy to make, and it exhibits a wide range of colors. I like to cut out the white core, though you can use it. It doesn't matter either way. And then once you get the white core out or leave it, cut that half into a quarter, and then cut those into thin strips. It varies on how large you want it, but just cut thin strips all the way through till you get them completely done. Then take your thin strips and fill up your blender till it's all the way to the top. You don't want to compress it down, so you're just going to fill it up all the way to the top. I end up making two batches, but I'm only showing you one here. So once you get that, then I boiled some water and poured 2 cups of water into here. And then you kind of just pulse it so it mixes up the solution, and breaks up the cabbage and makes it more into a liquid. So once you get to that point from there, then you're going to take a strainer and a coffee filter. And so you take your coffee filter and put it inside your strainer, and then very carefully pour slowly in so you don't go over the outside of the coffee filter, because there's more than there should be. So keep going a little slow and pour that until it goes all the way in, and then it'll drain down. Like I said, I made 2 batches of this. I'm only showing you one. There is 2 different ways to make the pH indicator. One, like I'm doing with the blender and making it more into a liquid. The other way is not using a blender and just putting boiling hot water onto the strips. The only difference there is we're coming up with a dark purple this way when we really blend it up. When you don't blend it up, you get more of a bluish, dark blue pH indicator, but they still work the same. I prefer it this way because you get more of a brighter color when we do our experiment. The red cabbage contains a pigment molecule called flavin. This water-soluble pigment is also found in apple skin, plums, poppies, cornflowers, and grapes. So here I go, I'm going to start pouring in my pH red cabbage into the different mixtures. Sprite first, and then I go to bleach next. Change it a little bit there. Then I'm going to water, straight water there. And then I go to baking soda solution. I mixed about 2 tablespoons of baking soda. Hand sanitizer, 2 tablespoons of hand sanitizer and water. Sugar solution, 2 tablespoons of sugar, and stirred it there. Vinegar, straight vinegar, and lemon juice. A little bit of water there. And you can see it changes the colors. I'll move it around a little bit, but the very acidic solutions will turn a red color, where neutral solutions result more of a purplish color, and basic solutions appear to be greenish or yellow. Therefore, it's possible to determine the pH of the solution based on the color it turns from the pigments of the red cabbage juice. Do not drink any of these liquids at any point. Make sure you have an adult helping you with this fun experiment. Here are the different color ranges for the pH and the colors that goes with it, and the different colors, the way they go from basic, neutral, and acidic. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to click thumbs up and to subscribe. Thanks for watching.